Hello, hello. Anyone there? hi, Bellum. All right. No. It is Monday. So today, what I'll be doing on stream, and it's Monday. Yes, I just finished cleaning up my lab because I was building a drone earlier. I was gonna do it on a stream, but like I was debating, like, would this be good stream content? And I didn't think so. So you saw a picture of the drone. I'm working on beams here. Honestly, this is something I was supposed to do like earlier today, but ran out of time. So here we are. Problem statement for today is, well, first of all, let me just say this horrific structure you see in front of you was something I made about 3 years ago. Everything is good stream content. Yeah, but I really didn't feel like being on stream for like 8 hours, starting from like 5 p.m. So, see, I made this 3 years ago for Hyperloop, and I realized I didn't tell stream or update stream as to what's going on, so I'll do that here. Pretty much what happened is the Hyperloop competition died, you know? So SpaceX decided, oh, let's not have Hyperloop anymore, so they took down their track, which made us sad. And this was, you know, what was supposed to be, what it was supposed to be, Hyperloop. So this semester, I was like, okay, if we don't have the big competition, let me just make my own. So this is for Hyperloop Mini. I am going to be making a smaller version of this and then pumping it out on 3 of my Belties for the entire semester. And hopefully, you know, through that, we'll be able to make a more functional, smaller train system thing. Yeah. So the goal of this stream is to make a smaller track that can be modular and replicable. You know, this thing, let me show you the size of this, the absolute size. And I'm gonna make the smaller beam a little bit, you know, smaller and all, but you know, let me just change it to millimeters. This was a very terrible design back when I didn't understand tolerances, Hyvie Grit. And these beams don't actually fit with each other very well. Let me show you. So like for example, this little piece right here is 5.08 millimeters, which is like 0.2 inches or something. And this one is 6.35. So there's a 1+ millimeter difference between these two pieces. Hi, Huskabite. I have a video for you. Oh, cool. How are you doing? I am doing okay. I don't usually stream on weekdays anymore due to the fact that school is murdering me slightly. Just buy a real I-beam. You know, if we bought a real I-beam, that'd probably save me the effort. But, you know, 3D printing stuff is funny, so... Hi, Kandarsa. Let me see what this is. What is this? Swerve testing 2023. Oh! I was about to say, this is beautiful. Y'all should boost views on it. Oh, I didn't fall over. Tragic. Anyways, it's very cool. Very cool. You should boost views on it, yeah. 3D printing stuff is funny, you should make that your site's tagline. Hey, it gets the views, it gets the clicks, it gets the things. Alright. Your pain gets the clicks, that is true. Speaking of pain, I haven't scheduled that exercise stream yet, so I will do it later. Next stream, lock for 3D prints, 3D printers. Oh man. So the idea behind this is I'm gonna go ahead and just scale this down. Scale this down 0.5 and then print it. Because I believe that if I scale it down 0.5, then it'll actually be like a reasonable length. But you know, I designed this using inches. RepRap.org, here we go. I do have some RepRap parts. I was gonna fix a mono price, but like, I never did. I will be back, I'm gonna be responsible and drive home. All right, see you later, Huskabite. Yeah, so, you know, we're gonna make a modular track. I don't know what the dimensions of this is. Like, I made this a long time ago. You could probably buy a cheaper track, but hey, 3D printers, they're funny. So I'm gonna do a little bit of rounding here. Let me just grab some, like, my notepad, get some dimensions. Like, the design of this I-beam is going to be completely changed. Alright. I wonder if you can do some aluminum extrusion. Probably. So I'm going to make the middle 5 millimeters. And then right here... also five. Should I just make the entire thing a 5 millimeter by 5 millimeter I-beam? That'd be really funny. And then down here, it's also 5 millimeters. It's like printing train track. Actually, Bell, you might be right. There may be no point to this stream. Hold on, let me check on the cost of like an I-beam at Home Depot. Okay. According to Home Depot, I-beam. Ah. A 3-inch by 2-inch by 170-inch I-beam for 4 feet is $115. This is very expensive. Yeah, no, okay. 3D printing is actually kind of... I hate to say it, but it's probably the better option in this scenario. It's a little expensive. It's out of my budget right now. All right, so 5 millimeter by 5 millimeter by 5 millimeter, and then the length of it, 61.9 millimeters. Let's do 62. I'm just using some conservative rounding here, you know? We're gonna do 60 just to make it even. I might do 60. All right, and then the fillets. Let's do let's see here. 0.75 millimeter fillet on that end. That is a 6.35 millimeter radius. Okay. I will go ahead and round that down to 6 millimeters. And you know, theoretically, this is for a competitive standpoint, so 0.75. Okay, so the height of this. I'm gonna round that down to 60. Okay. And then I'm gonna have to establish like a keep out zone. Like down here and up there. Probably like a 5 millimeter, 5 millimeter. Okay. Great. So let's make this file. Only $130 and 520 pounds each. Oh my goodness. Steel I-beam 13 feet. Okay, let's see. So that piece, okay. So I for a fact know aluminum is greater than steel, but you know what's greater than both of those? Plastic. So I happen to know that this is 50 grams of filament. So I can print 20 of these. This is about 4 inches, I believe. So this is about 4 inches, and I can print 20 of these, and that will be around $16, right? $20, give or take. And so 4 times 20 would be 4 inches times 20, which is 80 inches. So let's round that down to 72 inches, which is 9 feet. 9 feet would be 16. 9 feet of this I-beam is $16, $20. 9 feet of I-beam is $20. Do you need to be structural or just the right size and shape? What's the electric cost? We're gonna say about 24, 2.4 cents an hour. It's a racetrack. Well, it is holding up something, but it is hopefully gonna be structural enough. We'll see about the structural part once I print out one track for Supposed to be structural, but I'm taking a bunch of shortcuts here just to like. I'm taking a bunch of shortcuts here. When you're structural engineer. Hey, didn't you say this back when I created the Hyperloop the first time, Bellum? This thing is 60 millimeters by 60 millimeters. All right, watch. We're gonna make this real quick, and I'm gonna go like do my homework or something. All right, 60 millimeters by 60 millimeters. 5 millimeters like up and down. No gusset on the top. What is a gusset? That's something I'm gonna have to Google. A usually diamond-shaped or rectangular insert in a seam, as a sleeve, pocket book, or shoe to provide expansion or reinforcement. I think I'm looking at the wrong thing. Gusset structure. Ah, that's what it is. That's what you call that? Basically, Canarsis says I gotta put something like right here to support this overhang. Which, Canarsis, you're right. That's why you have the keep-out zone. But we'll figure that out later. Don't know what the heck a gusset is. Wrong type engineer, Kadarsa. Hey, I now know what a gusset is. What type are you? Not a gusset type? If you add a gusset, you also need a gullet. I'm the type of engineer that will build an automated sink to prevent myself from fixing my actual sink. Six millimeters. Oh, what happened to my other line? My future employers are gonna see this and be like, he's not fit for the industry. He's not fit for work. There's no offset on there. 0.75. Zero point seven five. Hi, Power Mike. How's it going? Alright, you know what? Good enough. Boom, extrude that. So, how many millimeters are in a feet? Millimeter to feet. 300. 300 millimeters in a foot. So, theoretically, if I print like a 300 beam of this. Wow, look, an I-beam. Lesson on gussets. So, this is gonna be the small track, I guess. And then, small. I did a little bit of conservative rounding, so it's a little square, but, you know, theoretically this should be able to... Do I have Creality Ball on this computer? I do. Okay. So this is like one piece of track. Do I want to make this like a good number for like Enders to print? Do I want Ender 3s to print this? He might be able to sandwich two cheaper C channels together and get what you want for much cheaper than structural steel. I mean, I'm literally only going to be using it for this semester, so I'm literally going to be printing this instead. Yeah, because you're gonna end up having colleagues print the free. You know what? Let's see how long it takes to print this first, and then I will decide from there. Test I beam. Let's call it that. Open up Creality Belts. In no universe do I have the financial capability to get a beam of steel. I am very much broke. Spend too much money on printers. I know a guy. Still gonna take some money. Can the school buy it? I mean, even... Like, I'm pretty sure I'm broke, like, financially, personally, and also the projects I'm in are also broke, so... Haven't built a whole Hyperloop track like the one SpaceX had in front of their HQ. That's what I'm trying to get right now, but, like, you know... School don't got money. Alright, so we've got a test beam here. I'm using a 0.8 nozzle. Let's see how long it takes. That's like 369 grams. That's a third of... Actually, that's not bad. That's the third of a kilo, which is about $4. Electricity cost. 2 cents an hour. For, like, let's just round it up to 20 hours. It's like 40 cents. 50 cents. For like $5. This beam is $5. Incorrect, your school is your money. Yours will deform in the sun. True. The heat's gonna take the structure away. It's not bad. It's about the same as... This is actually about the same as that AR marker ground station I printed. It's not bad. 17 hours. Do I do it, guys? Do I go for it? Do I go for the track? Not great, not terrible. Yeah. Should I just print one and see what happens? It's gonna be a fair amount of printing. How will it connect? Well, we're gonna deal with that, Bellum, in a bit, you know? We're gonna deal with that in a bit. You know, I actually have to lose my mentality of having infinite budget on projects and actually, like, be concerned about money this time around, you know? Hot glue? No, not hot glue. Not hot glue. You need to connect before doing a test run. You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and make this a lot smaller. I'm gonna do, like, 150 instead. If it, like... Actually, not even 150. Let me just do 100. Actually... Yeah, 100's fine, right? 100's fine. Structural string. So that parameter I can change later. Let me just make a... So I'm going to make a divot here. Okay, so... The connection mechanism. There we go. I'm completely honest with you guys. 3D printers are basically hot glue guns. I have never heard something more true in my life before. Oh, this is not. Oh, this is not. Oh, this is. This is not. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. Okay. So I'm thinking, right? We have like 2.2 millimeter hole. Yeah. Okay, and then I put this as like 57.5 or 55. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do a little bit of CADing here. Okay. Let's split this in half. Split this in half again. Mirror this down here. No. Let's not this line. Okay. And then we'll have it connect like all the way. Right? Because the last prototype I made of this beam, it didn't go well. Okay, so hear me out, guys. This goes inwards, I think. -5 millimeters. Right. And then on the other end, it's basically the same thing, except this time it's outwards. And also, because it's outwards, you need a tolerance of 1 millimeter. Which means you just map this to the back. And then you do an offset of 0.5, which I don't think this will even print. This won't print. This won't print. The nozzle is 0.8. This is just like one line. This is not gonna print. Okay, we're not Legoing this. Yeah, we can't Lego this. No. Go back. Yeah, we're gonna have to do plan B. So this is gonna be a 100 millimeter track. I'm gonna make it into a component and then make a copy of it. On this side. And then on this side. This is like way too small to do Lego method. So what I think we can do instead, actually, I just got an idea. So we just utilize this fat part down here, right? To align the blocks. So I create a circle thing. Wait a sec, could you buy a few planks of wood and with Lowe's to do this? You know how expensive I mean, do you know how expensive wood is these days? Like, I walk into a Lowe's and you can't even buy a plank of wood for less than, like, $3 at this point. It's, like, so expensive. Like, I think that 3D printing this might actually be more cost efficient than buying wood. It's expensive. And, like, so is PVC pipe. What's expensive? You don't even think it grows on trees? I feel like it's cheaper than brain power and price. Yeah, but you also gotta cut wood. And, you know, like, working with machinery is not my strong suit. Let's do 6. So 6 being the divot and 5 being the outwards thing. Wood doesn't grow on trees, right? Wait, it does. Wood grows on trees. So I'll just put that in there, and then on the other side, I'll have a peg going outwards. And that'll connect on the bottom. Right? 5. And I'll have the 1 millimeter indent. -5 like that. Nope, I did that wrong. 5. No, go outwards. No, what? No, it's not cutting. What? 5. Okay. That's gonna print because Belty loves this kind of shape. Okay, and then all we gotta do is copy. I didn't copy that. Move, copy, create, copy, push this outwards like this. And then copy this again. Tolerance. This tolerance is gonna work. Hey, it's gonna work. What else are we gonna do with the spare sticks in the locker? Money is made out of cotton and paper, so it also grows on trees. If you made the beam small. Yeah. What if we just made the beam smaller? What would we do then? Like, height-wise, be it smaller. Like, okay. So this would work, and then we make something to connect it on the bottom, right? I don't have a good idea of, like, how people are going to make this pod, though. Because, it's a 50% scale. Need space for wheels. I didn't think this one through very well. Yeah, I think it'll be fine. I think it'll be okay, because this is pretty small. Anyways. Hindsight 2020. I'll just go for it and see what happens afterwards. Okay. These are relative copies, so whatever I do to this piece, I'll do to the other one. Just project that. Okay. And then I'll add some screws here in order to get this. So this will be 20.75. Is that the middle? Wait. Okay. YOLO, the project. What's the worst thing that can happen? Financial ruin? Yeah. Money go bye-bye. We're all gonna be broke. I don't have enough investment in this project to make this last long. That's what's happening right now. Okay. Point, bam, 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 bam. This is a very small one. M3. Yeah, this is a very small model. three down. No, three down. Even three down goes almost all the way in. It's actually very small. Okay. So then... compared to the original one, or the original Hyperloop, this is very small. You know, we'll experiment and find out. You know, we'll mess around and find out. Identical, adjust. Okay, and then mirror this here. All right, so now we have our 100 millimeter piece of track here, and I realized that it didn't mirror that, so I have to go back. Things are very expensive these days, guys. I can't just go about spending money willy-nilly. Look, I haven't even gotten a new printer in like 3 months. That's how bad the economy is. Right. That's such a bad thing. I shouldn't be saying that. That's terrible. It's a terrible combination of words. Okay, so now we've got these tracks here. So these tracks will be connected on the bottom. Withdrawals. 3D printing withdrawals. That's what we're dealing with. Okay, so I'm gonna map this. Okay. Then it's gonna be 20.75, right? 20.75. So, like, just print one of these pieces out, like, by 5 millimeters, right? Yeah. 5 millimeters is like really huge. My headphones are running out of batteries. All right, I'm not gonna be able to hear chat or the music for like a while. So we just print out this block, right? Hear me out. We make the block like aesthetically pleasing. And then on the top here, we just take the bottom sketch, project it like that. And then we go ahead and make some holes. 2, 3, 4. Here. Oop, not there. Here. And these ones will be the countersunk holes. So 5 millimeters. Oop, 5 millimeters. It's 6 millimeters. 3 millimeters. 2 millimeters. And then 3.5. See, I've memorized it for an M3 now. Oh yeah, okay. So it's these pieces are gonna be joined. I'm so glad I didn't have. Oh my goodness! I'm so glad I didn't have the headphones on. First of all, but second of all, thank you so much, Project, for the $20 tip, to help fund the plastic IV. Hopefully, this doesn't result in financial ruin. Everyone watching right now. thank you to Project 454. I believe you have just sponsored me. How many feet of track is this? Like 1 foot of track, 2 feet of track, 3 feet of track. Sorry, chat. It was inevitable. But thank you so much, Project. It means a lot. All right, so now that we have this little piece that can go on like in between each track and hopefully make it a little bit better, join. You are welcome. The enabler. Yeah, I may or may not have forgotten that part about my channel. It's a good thing I removed my headphones at the right moment. Yeah, so pretty much this is gonna be like this. And I realize because I've screwed up the hole placements, it's because I did this instead of actually the right thing to do, which is like not to use these projections and rather use the sketch that was underneath. This is like the lazy way of doing it. So sketches, sketch. Not this one. This one. No. Well, which sketch was it? It was like sketch 4, sketch 5. It was this sketch. This sketch, which is not here right now. Okay. So what to do? What to do, what to do, what to do. Just make it your... I'm just gonna make it myself. I'm just gonna make it myself, you know? Make it myself. Okay. It was this sketch. This sketch. Maybe I go play Factorio. You know what? I still have to finish playing that game. I never actually finished playing that. Playing Factorio. You're gonna forget how to play. I am gonna forget how to play. You know, Bug's gonna get it. I've been making random Factorio references while talking about engineering things with my friends lately. It's been amusing. It's been a experience. Okay. And I'm trying to make an I-beam that is required for the project, but EMT conduit is fairly cheap and metal. Do I have to Google what this is again? EMT conduit. I just get a logo shipment from your area. These are tubes. Thinly walled conduit pipe that is often chosen in place for galvanized rigid contents. Made of coated steel and aluminum. See, metalworking scares me. The seller's name is Choi. I've heard that name here before. Yes, Choi is one of my viewers. It's been here in a while, though. It isn't Louis' choice. No, 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 it isn't. Fortunately or unfortunately, not my viewer. That would have been a hilarious small world moment. You know, the Choi, no, I don't think he's a Lego shipper. Okay. Mirror. This is like, I need like precision clicking for this. This does not feel right. Okay. Now that I've done that. Maybe it's a secret passion. Perhaps it is. Okay, now that I've got this piece down, pretty much this is gonna join the pieces. It's gonna look really weird. I have a button that makes my mouse sensitivity really low for precision clicking. I feel like it's gonna mess me up even more. If I'm gonna be honest here. You know, if I have these like pieces on both sides of the track, you think that'd be an eyesore? Or you know, let me try it. Create copy here. You think that would or would not be an eyesore? It's 37.5, right? No, it's like 38. No, it's 37.75. Okay. Looks like a domino. Indeed, indeed it does. Yeah, so this peg is gonna connect, and the bottom's gonna connect. And then I have to make, what was it called again? A gusset? A gullet? something to connect the top here, so that it's like structurally stable. What was it called again? Right, okay, so, the top. Yeah, so if I don't connect the top, it's gonna be tragic. But the middle beam is like 5 millimeters, so I'm gonna have to like stagger this, I think. Okay. So, let's see here. Can I have connectors on the side of the beam? I don't think so, because that's where the wheels are going to be. Because people who build stuff for this, or build a pod for it, need the side wheels to clamp onto. Yeah. For reference, I'm going to go take a look at the previous one I did. This was back in the winter of like 2021, I think. 2021. Winter of 2021, 2022. Remember when we designed this? This was done all in like 2 weeks span. This was my crowning achievement. I never designed something more cool in college. This was the peak. I peaked here. Anyways, yeah, this was the big pod. But I'm trying to make a smaller one. And so this is the smaller one. Small track. And the small track will actually have like neat ways of connecting with each other, including how am I going to screw this in? I forgot that I need to screw this stuff in. oh no. I'll find a way. We'll probably find a way. Okay. Main point of concern is probably like this part first, so. Allen wrench and hex heads. Hundreds of dollars of brass heat set inserts. it's gonna make the project cost more than if I just like bought a steel beam. I think I'm just gonna make like 10 millimeter by 10 millimeter areas like this, and then jam a screw hole into the middle of them. I probably could have done like something like that for the bottom one, but hindsight 2020. I'm not gonna change it now. Something like this. Point here, point here. Wait, no, I was supposed to zero. Yeah. So that it'd be this side, I think. Oop, hole. Oh my goodness. Yeah, so tapped hole. This is gonna destroy the beam. 3 millimeters deep. NCM. Come on. Oh no. Oh no. Hot glue. Oh no. It's crashing. My fusion's crashing on me. Oh, woe is me. Oh. Failed to build tool body. Well, that's the first time I heard of that. Oh, it's because it's going on. Oh, I know why it's doing that. It doesn't like being on the other beam. Okay. Right, because of that. So I have to go on here now. I have to go over here and then do the same thing here because these are two separate beans and yeesh. I sure hope that when I change the length of this beam, it doesn't crap out on me. It probably will. Story of my life. Oh, I didn't put a point. You know, I think this is the point in which I should probably go to sleep. Okay, so we've done that. Now, the other side, if I do the same thing, it's gonna... If I put holes on the other side in this same location, it's not gonna work because it'll go right through. So, the plan is, hear me out here. So, what we're gonna do is we are going to, basically split it. I have an idea. So it's gonna be 10, 10 like that. Then 10, 10 like that. And then on the second one, we will build the point and then drill it through the top. This will work, guaranteed. And then on this side, we'll do the exact same thing. And then we'll do it again. Okay, and then we'll do it here. Then we'll do it here. And then we'll do this here. Finish sketch, hole. Bam, bam. Okay. So that's going to be the left side. Now on the right side, now that I have an idea of what I'm doing, we're going to project this. I'm going to make this 10 by 10. I'm going to make this 10 by 10 again. We're going to make this 10 by 10. You know what? This is actually turning out to be quite nice. It's very meditative. You know, so it doesn't, you know, crash to the other region. I even put holes there. Point here, point here, finish sketch. And then hole. Bam, bam. Okay, and then on the top, now this time on the top it's gonna be the inner two, right? 10, 10, like that. 10, 10. And then here, 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 here. Oh, I didn't put points. Point here, point here. Finish sketch. Hole, hole here, hole here. Okay. All right, so now we have this for it's different on both sides, you know? It's different on both sides because it doesn't, you know, crash through into each other. Okay, so now we just have to connect the top using a hold on, I got this. Gusset, right? No, it's gusset, not gullet. It's gusset, right? It's gusset. It's gusset. So I'm gonna make a plane on here, drag it all the way down here. Maybe like 20 more. Like that. Okay. Now it's just a matter of making a triangle. Oh. Making a triangle from this point. Which is actually very large. Wow, okay. Okay. It's gonna be like this, right? Like a triangle. That's how triangles work, right? New body. Okay. So like that, I think. Ooh, but I'm gonna have to like put holes into this triangle in two different angles. Ooh. Ooh, that's gonna be fun. Okay, so how am I gonna do this? I have an idea. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this here. That's gonna be like the first one, right? Okay. So project that. And then so basically basically geometry. Geometry. Okay. How much do I like that? Oh, I like that a lot. Oh, I like that a lot. I like that a lot. Oh, yes, okay. Oh. Yes. Yeah, so it goes here and goes here. Oh, hi, Bricka Mode. How's it going? Did I say this was gonna be a short stream? It's been an hour already. Every single time I say it's a short stream, it never gets. It's, OMG, both of us are working on models. Why did I delete that? What? Blacklisted spam? Wait, what? Ignore Nightbot. Nightbot gets a little bit too crazy sometimes. Nothing wrong was said. That was really motivated. Racially motivated. Nightbot gets a little hangry sometimes. You gotta chill out, you know? Nightbot, chill out. Alright, so these ones are gonna be. No, they're just gonna be simple holes. Simple holes, you know. Hopefully they don't intersect with each other. I feel like they are. Not gonna lie. I feel like they are. Three. Is that three? Two point five. That's 2.5. Also, what's the longest screws we have in the room? I'm working on test bed thing and swear it will get my progress log in. 3 by 20 millimeters. 2.5. I feel like I feel like it's not gonna work. Yeah, it's five. But like the screw itself is like six, so it's gonna like s it's it that's not gonna work. Don't know, man. Would that work? That wouldn't work, right? Gonna shave off another millimeter. Go one more millimeter up. or like from here. Here, here, okay. I see, I feel like that's not gonna work either. I don't know, I'm conflicted. These screws are definitely not large enough because the diameter of the top is like 6 millimeters. So if I were to do this, it's gonna like hit something. So what to do, what to do? Nightbots deleted Bellum's messages? What? It doesn't like OMG. Hey, it didn't blacklist it that time. Hey, didn't blacklist at that time. Nightbot is onto something. That was my main account. Oh, dude, Bellum 256. The other one was an alt. Ah, I see. I see. I didn't even realize. Bellum's got alter egos. Nightbot timed out Bellum 256 for 600 seconds? Yeah, this should help. Bro, I'm about to make you drink water 28 times. Alright, you know what? I think that's enough streaming for today. I've got other work to do. I'll come back to this later. I'll print one of these beams out because I know it's finished. I just gotta figure out a way to like make this piece work. Gotta help the points stacked up. Alright, I'm done for today. You made him leave. No, I actually have to leave. It's 10. I actually have to leave now. I have work. work is important. Bellum 128 removed timeout on Bellum 256. That's hilarious. Alright, anyways, I'm gonna head off now. Well, thank you guys for watching. I will see you all later. Hey, Bellum 256 is red. Alright. Bye for now, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. Actually, maybe not tomorrow. Probably Wednesday, if not Wednesday, Thursday, if not Thursday, Friday, if not Friday, Saturday. Friday is not going to be here because of the workshop, but, you know. Who are we rating? I don't know. Who are we rating? I can put back my headphones on now. It's probably done charging. I'm going to go print one of these beams out and see what it looks like. Who are we rating? Papa Arvin is live. Oh, I remember Papa Arvin. All right, let's go. Let's go. Anyways, oh, I forgot to do my outro. That's been so long. Anyways, thanks for watching today. I will see you all later. Goodbye, good night. Have a great night. Bye-bye.